Save it for the podcast.
Save it for the podcast.
Me and Martin be saying that unironically now.
What?
He'll start to tell us a lot now, bro. Save it for the podcast.
Oh, yeah, honestly. Because it's better.
Yeah, I got something. What if somebody could only see
I said
through...
save it for the podcast.
What is this?
What is this? Hey, are you recording right now?
Bro!
Wait,
let's
random,
hear their
right?
voice, the voices back, to see if it works.
Rolling. What's
Wait,
up,
try
guy?
Try again. Alright, try again. I think it, there's a delay.
That's
right.
A horrible
hey guys,
often.
Welcome
nah,
to
nah,
the
nah,
Johncast.
Nah, nah,
I hijacked
nah,
his
nah,
intro.
Nah, nah, fuck We're rolling. I'm starting the podcast. Nobody
yeah.
else is.
All right.
It's just me.
It's
just
him.
Me here.
It's him and his schizophrenic voices.
I can make very good voice impressions. But yeah, welcome. We're going to be talking about a lot of random stuff. Mainly about childhood stuff,
yeah.
You know?
And just, you know, whatever comes to mind.
And we got guests. Three of them.
our temps, our interns, you know?
He keeps calling them that.
Yo, pay us, so call us unpaid at least.
Unpaid interns.
You're an intern.
It's your hosts. You know,
hostess with the mostest.
Chris. And your other host, Martin. Otherwise known as Panfa.
Why do you get the other ones?
Otherwise known as Cool Guy Chris.
There you go.
Ooh.
Yeah, there you go. All right, that's a good intro.
Yeah, okay.
you guys sound perfect.
Yo.
Perfectly not.
Yeah, exactly.
But my weird thought was, what if somebody could only see through, like, glasses, but they had to be, like, wine glasses and shit?
Oh
so
God.
Solid.
Wait,
so they have to sort of, had to like. Oh, I need to see you. Hold on. Where are you? Oh, there you are.
They're just
so they just have to put it in front of their eye, and then like, but like, have it resting on surfaces. So you walk into this dude's house, and there's just like these layers of wine glasses of different things.
Right,
you're like, wow,
right.
This must be a wine enthusiast. Don't pick that up. Don't drink from it. It's here so I can see you.
But what if they go out? Where
no.
are they going to keep the
they
glass?
They don't go out. They're at home. They don't live anywhere. They don't walk around with wine glasses.
You would never
eyes.
Pass the driver's test.
No,
yeah.
Yeah.
We need both hands.
No, just put
and
the wine glass
the
on top
part.
Of the dashboard.
Stupid.
What, all right, make a left turn.
It breaks.
And the best part is, they're actually an artist. So you see this giant magnifying glass thing with just a wine glass at the bottom. So they're like drawing or something artsy. And they're just like, yes. This is how I live my life and make my living. People pay for this shit.
They pay to see this shit.
You know, a random thought. When I was younger, I always wondered how did planes fly?
Oh,
yeah. You know? Like, because one moment they're on the ground. And next they're in the sky.
Honestly?
It's just wild. And it's like, it maintains in the sky. And then like, how does it move? But then, I guess I still don't know how planes work. Well, I'm not a
turbine.
Hey,
Your dad, how do planes work?
You know how planes work?
You really want to know?
He's like, you want me to get into the mechanics? And the...
Yeah, it's for a podcast. Come here.
Oh, it's a brief summary on how airplanes work. Enlighten me.
He's getting ready.
It generates lift.
This is the speaker over here, Dad.
So I know it generates lift.
It generates lift.
Perfect. That solves all the problems.
Perfect.
As a plane moves through the air, the upper surface is of further distance than the lower surface, and yet the way the physics works, the air that comes at the beginning together when it splits, it's still the same at the back end.
Mm-hmm.
But the one with the shorter one taking the longer distance is thinner, less dense than what's below, so it's buoyant, so it pushes up, and that's what causes the lift. Nice. Mm. So that's why a plane works as it moves through the air. Oh. It's the air on the top of the wing is a little less dense. The air on the bottom of the wing stays its density, and so it pushes it up.
Nice.
Wow. That's how it works. And you can get into angle of attack and a whole bunch of other things, but that's the basic.
There you have it, folks. Intro to planes.
Yeah. Plane
explanation. go research in Google.
They have plenty of engineering courses on aeronautical engineering.
Oh, nice. Wow. That's something I've thought of going into before.
Yeah, he was almost an aerospace engineer.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's why he went into ESET.
Imagine an alternate universe
where I turn into pilots. Oh my god. We meet each other in the pilot academy.
Instead of ships.
Yeah, instead of saying okay ships, we're like, alright, pilot.
You're pushing pilot?
Yeah. No, even worse. You're there to be the chef for the base to train the aeronautical engineers. Because none of them can cook for shit. maybe eat that, but he's like, I don't know, I can bake.
Yeah. I can bake and do like 3 barrels in the sky.
Barrels.
Those aren't maneuvers, those are just pastries.
Alright, Panfo, you got any
Panfo?
Any random thoughts?
Random thoughts.
You don't have to leave.
What if the world is really just different shades of green?
Is that why you're colorblind?
So like, BB, I'm colorblind. The fuck?
So if the world is really just different shades of green,
50 shades
then
of green?
What is green?
Oh my god.
The true
green is
green?
Everything.
So is that why everything? What is green?
I think you're just blind.
I'm thinking of it now. What is it
right
now?
I'm colorblind. I can't hear.
Contemplating, like, what is green then?
What do you think? Like, different shades of green turn into blue, red, yellow, and what all those other colors?
That's some white shit.
That would be
white, right? White goes into all the other colors.
What if white
good question
is green? Because we don't know what green is, except green is everything. So green is white, what is green?
Wouldn't green be white then?
Honestly, I always wondered, like, how did people come up with words to describe words? Like,
you mean how did people create language?
What if it was just sounds
that doesn't
evolved
that doesn't
words
even make sense? Like,
I think that is
what
it is.
How did they know what
it's just like
the color red?
Some Sims talk.
Judges for
a
this?
Yeah, what if that's what happened?
Oh my
and
god.
Then a region came with that
to who, what up? What's a really distant, like, relatively unknown country that...
Wakanda?
No.
Wakanda, yeah.
You know, that actually exists, bro.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's a real place. I mean, they don't got vibranium or none of that.
Oh, yeah.
Shwa-shwa is a slur in Wakanda?
And that's how we got Fushwa. It's turned into Fusha, so like...
And then we got
Fushigi.
Wow. Fushigi, not the ball.
Fushigi ball.
That ball was a ripoff. That was a scam.
Yeah, he was just like fondling it.
Yeah, he was like, ooh,
$20 ball.
And it was literally made of glass, so if it fell, it just broke.
It's just like,
it's
don't
here.
Don't break it. Don't drop it. Don't do any of this. But you know, magical.
It's sleeping the nation. Like, come on, bro.
It's worse than worm on a string.
But you know who wasn't a scam? That, Phil, what's his name? Phil Swift?
Oh, yeah, fucking,
yeah, boy,
the Slap Chop.
We have that!
Does it work?
Yeah, it does!
It's so good.
It's so good, bro!
How about the Flex Seal?
The Flex Seal?
Oh,
the Flex Seal.
What's his name?
I saw this boat in here.
What's his name,
Phil Swift?
What, the Shamwell guy? Oh, wait, no.
Phil Swift was the Flex Seal.
He's the Flex Seal,
yeah.
You talking about OxyClean?
No, that's another guy.
Mr. Green?
No, that's another guy. Hold on.